Hi participants, good morning. Welcome to this online knowledge sharing program on triple offset butterfly valves. This is Maduraiveeran from LIT Valves. Now we move on the subject of today, triple offset butterfly valves. Butterfly valves are not new to this world. It was invented 2 centuries back. There are many types of butterfly valves exist. We have now the most popular evolved version of triple offset butterfly valves used in industry. Today we are going to discuss on triple offset butterfly valve covered in AP 609. It has got 3 offsets with multiple benefits. See, as a general human being, there is always a tendency to have one medicine to solve all the health problems. In practical, it is not possible. In piping industry, the expectation is one solution to solve all the issues relevant to valves. Yes, we have a solution that is in the name of a triple offset butterfly valve. Let us see how it overtakes other valves. See, gate valve is a torque-seated valve and better seated, suitable for many applications, but takes more time for operation. A ball valve solves this issue. The problem in a gate valve, it is solved by a ball valve because it is a quarter turn valve quick to operate, but it is not suitable for throttling application. That problem is solved by a standard butterfly valve, which is having a soft seat that provides a throttling application. But the problem is the soft seated butterfly valve is not suitable for high temperature services. Because it is having interference, we need to provide the soft seat. So it is not suitable for high temperature application. So we have to eliminate the interference. One such valve is a check valve, which is having a non-interference, non-rubbing seat, but it can't provide the all other solutions. So triple offset butterfly valve is a combination of all these valves that provides a solution to the industry. Now you can understand the power of triple offset butterfly valve. Today we are going to discuss a valve classification overview, evolution of triple offset design, its features, its standards, its applications, and triple offset valve versus gate and tunnel mounted valves. Valves are generally classified in terms of function, operation, and seating. Let us see how the butterfly valve fits into these classifications. Functions include isolation, regulation, non-return, safety, and control. Butterfly fits into the regulation category, but it is also suitable for isolation. Under operation, there are categories like multi-turn, quarter-turn, and self-actuated. Butterfly fits into the quarter-turn, which makes it quick operation. Seating includes position seated valves, torque seated valves. Butterfly valve is a torque seated valve. Now we move on to the standards. This is generally covered in AP 609. There are 2 categories in AP 609, category A and category B. Category A valves are cold working temperature valves and pressures. It is generally covered up to 2 inches to 48 inches in ASCP class 125 or 150. Category B valves are applicable for ASCP 16.34, class 150 to class 600, full rated pressure and temperature ratings. ranging from 3 inches to 48 inches. Under category A, soft-seated concentric butterfly valves are covered and suitable for low pressure and temperature applications. Under category B, double offset and triple offset butterfly valves are covered. The double offset valves are prominently soft-seated and suitable for low pressure and temperature applications. Triple offset butterfly valves are with metal seat and suitable for high pressure and temperature applications. We are going to see how the triple offset design got evolved. So you are seeing the zero offset valve, where the seat plane and the body seat are in same plane. So here the interference happens all around the disc plane because it is a soft seated valve. You can see it is having rubbing during operation due to interference to have sealing. You can see the red color indication where the rubbing takes place. So this is the main disadvantage of a rubber lined butterfly valve. That is a disadvantage of a concentric valve. That is going to reduce the life up some time, torque increase after some time. Now we move on to the first offset. To overcome the problems, what is faced in the zero offset design? First offset is nothing but shifting the axis of shaft from seat plane is called first offset. This also requires a soft seat and is not suitable for high pressure and temperature application because it is also going to have rubbing. Now we are going to see about the double offset design. See, in the double offset design, the hub axis, that is shaft axis, is further shifted down. And that is called the second offset. This is basically introduced to have the sealing effective compared to the first offset alone design. The valve having a first offset alone will not seal properly, but valve with the second offset will provide sealing better. See, when the flow medium is on the preferred direction, the hub side is the preferred direction, the opposite side is called the non-preferred direction. When the flow takes place from the preferred direction, this second offset will provide very good sealing. In addition to the torque, the line pressure itself will provide sealing. Same time, when there is a flow from the non-preferred direction, the opening of valve is very easier. So depending on the application, the flow direction is used actually with the second offset valves. Here also the interference takes place. So soft seal only prominently used for this design. So till double offset, using the metal seat is not feasible because it is having interference. You can see the double offset interference is marked in the red of this animation. So that is why prominently the soft seat is used for this application. Then how to overcome this? Now let us understand the profile of the seating arrangement in double offset. In the double offset valve, the seat face resembles the glow valve conical seat. The seating force is applied on a glow ball to affect the ceiling. In double offset valve, butterfly valve, in addition to the torque, flow medium aids the ceiling due to the second offset. Okay, now how to eliminate this rubbing concept what we have discussed? Let us see. By understanding the profile, this is the cone profile which is available in the double offset. This is the cone profile. If this cone profile is changed to this kind of a profile, the interference while rotating the disc is eliminated. That is what invented, and that is what called triple offset. That is what we are going to see further. The cone what you have seen concentric to the pipeline axis is shifted down and made this profile almost horizontal to the pipeline axis. At this condition, if you rotate from this shaft axis, the rubbing is totally eliminated. This is the old profile. Now this is the current profile because of this tilting the cone. The tilting the cone is called triple offset. For each and every size, this first offset, second offset, and third offset, it is arrived by the geometry principles. These three combinations will make rubbing free design, interference free design. That provides the body seat only body seat contacts only at the end of the operation, and there is no rubbing takes place. That provides the option of using metal seats for triple offset butterfly valves, and then it become almost equal to other valves like gate valves, metal seated gate valves. It is equal, or metal seated cadence mounted valves. It is equal. Or metal seated global, it become equal. So that makes it suitable for high temperature and pressure applications. This is the cone, tilted condition cone is shown there. This is a double offset cone, and this is the triple offset cone which is tilted, which makes a rubbing free rotation of the seal. Remember, this kind of a profile machining is not an easy work, easy machining method. It is a very tedious method to make this tilted cone machining condition, because when you machine this, only one point at a time of the tool will be touching it. Other portion it will not be touching. Actually, when it touches here, the tool may be the other place here. Similarly, when it touches here, the tool will travel here. So machining this will be a very tedious process. We require all special machines for this. Now you are watching the animation of triple offset valve. You can see that only at the end it goes and touches, and when the torque is applied through the shaft, then the torque is transmitted to the laminar seal, this seal. That is like a elliptical shape cam profile, so that force is converted and acted on the laminar seal and exerts further force on the seating face. The laminar seal also expands at that time and provides the tight sealing on the body seat. That makes the sealing tight, which will provide a zero leakage. When there is a flow from the preferred direction, it is aiding the sealing. When the flow from the non-preferred direction also, already the laminar seal is already in good contact with the seat face, so it is also providing the sealing from the non-preferred side. So that is how this triple offset design makes this butterfly valve truly bidirectional. Can see once again how the non-rubbing rotation takes place. You can observe the zero offset design. See, that is how, see, zero offset design is the first design where one segment, small segment of the ball valve is used for constructing the butterfly valve. But it requires a interference for sealing. Double offset also, it is having an interference. Soft seat is prominently required. Triple offset, no interference. So there is no need of any soft seat here. We can use straight away implement metal seat. This is what we have already discussed. Just to recap, concentric disc friction throughout the operation takes place. In the double offset, almost after 50% of the operation, the rubbing takes place. In triple offset butterfly valve, after seating the face, the torque is applied for effecting the metal to metal sealing. Or in other words, to make the laminar seal to expand on the seat faces, the torque is applied. The laminar seal provides the uniform compression around the entire seat, hence zero leakage observed. The body seat and disc seal come in contact only at the final shutoff position. It minimizes the wear, enhances the valve life. See, unlike rubber lined butterfly valves, the seat faces are getting worn out because of the rubbing and interference. Whereas in the laminar seal design, it goes and work for operations after operation, even though it is a metal to metal contact, thus the life is enhanced because of the interference free opening and closing of valve. That makes the torque also lower. This is a recap on all the three offsets: zero offset, double offset, and triple offset. Concentric rubber lined valve, soft seated double offset valve, and metal seated triple offset. This is a recap on advantages of each gate, butterfly, non-standard butterfly, and ball valve and check valve. All put together, triple offset butterfly valve has got the advantages of all these four valves. This is an exploded view of the butterfly valve, triple offset butterfly valve, body, a disc, and laminar seal fitted onto the disc using a retainer, a single piece shaft. It is having a gland packing arrangement similar to a gate valve or a globe valve. Shaft bottom is fitted with a thrust plate, and that is retained by the retainer bottom core plate. This gland packing and then bottom cover arrangements makes the internals safe. It becomes truly a metal seated valve comparable with the gate valve. So the emission to the atmosphere is avoided, and this is the operating arrangement, quarter turn operating arrangement. The typical construction of triple offset butterfly valve. Ends can be anything. Okay, Now we move on to the features of triple offset butterfly valve. So far we have seen the evolution of triple offset and triple offset butterfly valve parts. Triple offset butterfly valve is a truly a double tight shutoff valve achieved by the triple offset geometry because of the uniform seal contact. It is having the wedging effect at the final torquing operation. Self-adjusting, this laminar seal is a self-adjusting to the profile of the mating body seat. When we apply the torque, this floating laminar seal adjusts to the profile of the body seat and provides the sealing. That makes it a uniform compression and provides the bidirectional sealing. This is truly a intrinsic fire safe valve in comparable with the gate valve, metal seated gate valve or a metal seated glue valve. As I explained earlier, all the internals are prevented by gland packing and bottom cover with a gasket arrangement. So it is having a low emission capability and safe to the atmosphere. This triple offset butterfly valve have a typical anti-blowout features. The shaft is provided with a thrust plate and which acts like a collar, which is locked between the bottom bush and then that is one of the anti-blowout feature. At the gland packing area, the gland is having a strip there. Shaft also having a strip there. So that is also locked. So this is another anti-blowout feature typically followed in triple offset butterfly valves. And triple offset butterfly valves are versatile for adding any much more features. You can see the n types of the butterfly valve. The short pattern butterfly valve is a wafer flangeless butterfly valve. Is a wafer lugged butterfly valve and butt valve butterfly valve. As you all know, flange valves are easily fitted like other gate valve or a glow valve. A wafer flangeless valve is actually a very, very thin face-to-face dimension. This is the lowest weight valve available in the world. Having all these features, I'm telling you. The only thing is that installation of this valve has to be taken care properly in such that when you open the disc, that will protrude beyond the face-to-face. So when you are installing, it has to be installed with the valve closed condition and properly this flange holes, no, mating holes provided at the top and bottom are aligned with the pipeline flanges and carefully installed. Then only we have to open the disc. Otherwise, there are chances for a rubbing of the seat arrangement, sealing arrangements with the pipeline ID. And our technical documents like GAD, General Assembly Drawing, will provide what is the protruding diameter of this valve. So any pipeline ID used should be more than the protruding ID dimension. Unlike this wafer valve, this lugged valve can easily be installed in the pipeline because it is having a tapping or drill hole all around the periphery, so you can easily install it. Wafer flangeless valves require only one set of bolts for installation. Wafer lugged valves also, if there is a through hole, you can use only one set of bolts, studs and nuts. Otherwise, two sets of bolt nuts are required here. Bottled valve for very safe applications. It is used for such applications. We have two varieties of flange valves: short pattern and long pattern. Short pattern is actually preferred because of the weight reduction, compactness. But long pattern valves are preferred where there are some replacement to gate valves are considered. It has got varieties of operations like hand wheel, electrical, electro hydraulic, and pneumatic actuation. Or you name any actuation, it is possible. There are some special features like a steel jacket. Applications we can provide where need to contain the heat the line medium, which will get solidified kind of a thing. This kind of a special features can be provided. Okay, now we move on to the standards. Basic valve design followed as AP 609 category B, pressure rating 16.34. It is generally like any gate valve. The standard compliance is to any gate valve other than the valve design standard AP 609 and mounting clamp as per ISO 5210. You name any material, that metal can be supplied. Globally, all the materials are available, starting from carbon steel to super duplex stainless steel. Applications. You name any industry, this butterfly valve can be employed. Starting from oil and gas, petrochemicals, steel plant, power, pulp and paper, refining. It is starting from oil and water, oil, gas to any application, it is suitable. The range is covered as per AP 609 are 3 inches to 48 inches per triple offset butterfly valve. ACV classes 150 to 600. Of course, we can, the valve industry is making 900 and 1500 also. But that valve we called under ASME 60 B16.34. In my opinion, beyond 1500 is not feasible because you will not be seeing any flow bore exist in the valve. So basically, this valve, when you fully open, the disc arrangements along with the shaft will be the obstruction to the flow. So when you are selecting the triple offset butterfly valve, the CV value, flow coefficient is important to know, and it has to be compared with the flow conditions at the line, and it has to be sized accordingly. Now we are going to see some glimpses of butterfly valves. The standard valve, the cryogenic triple offset butterfly valve, is an actuated triple offset butterfly valve. The valve with steam purging, and for high temperature, this kind of a fin arrangement is provided on a triple offset butterfly valve typically. In my opinion, there is no size limit for making a triple offset butterfly valve. What you're seeing is a 100 inch triple offset butterfly valve. Okay, to summarize, when triple offset butterfly valve comes to your mind, it is a light in weight, occupies lesser space, constant torque after years of operation, it provides zero leak, opens at fully rated differential pressure. Let us just compare this valve with a gate valve, trunnion mounted ball valve, and a triple offset butterfly valve. whatever the shortfalls we are having in a gate valve, it is overcome by the triple offset butterfly valve. Similarly, the shortfalls in TMEV also taken care of. Of course, as I mentioned, flow coefficient is one of the parameter you have to consider when we are deciding TOPV. In my opinion, many a cases higher CV valves are used. Higher CV gate and trunnion mounted valves are used. Even there is a flow conditions permits triple offset butterfly valve, considering the pressure drop requirements at the site. This is a typical image of TOPV compared with the trunnion mounted ball valve and gate valve. Hi, we have our in our portfolio GGC ball valves, butterfly valves, control valves, and marine valves, choke valves, valve automation solution, and digital solutions.